Hello everyone, welcome to our channel LexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and this is part 3 of the visualization series. If you want to watch the part 1 and the part 2, you can just click on the I button on the right hand side corner. In this particular video, I'll be talking about a library called Seaborn in Python programming language, which basically helps you create method based graphs. The speciality of this particular library is that even if you are using a method based plot, you can also use matplotlib on top of it to mention your title labels, to mention your x labels, y labels, to create the kind of labels the way you want to. You can also add text to your text to your graphs, because this particular library is built on top of matplotlib library, so it basically helps you use all the methods which are available in matplotlib library on top of it, so that you can make your graphs more flexible. Or in case if you don't want to make your graphs that much flexible and you just want a plot, that's it, with your data you can just use Seaborn library, that's it. So let's get back to our Jupyter notebook and see how we can create beautiful plots with the help of Seaborn library. Without wasting any further time, let's get back to it. So in this particular video, I will be using a data called tips data, which is already predefined or is given in the Seaborn library. So what I am doing here is I am just calling out or importing the library Seaborn by simply writing import Seaborn as SNS, import matplotlib.pyplot as PLT, in case if we want to use, you know, those methods which help us create titles and labels on the graph. That is why we are importing matplotlib library. Then I am also mentioning percentage matplotlib inline here to keep the plot within the parameters of this Jupyter notebook. Here I am using a variable called tips, within which I am just loading the tips data in this. So I am writing SNS dot load underscore dataset. Within that I am just calling out the tip dataset, and then I am just looking at tips dot head 5. And I'm just looking at how my top 5 rows of the data set look like. So let's run this entire thing once again. It is again just going to take some time. So because here you can see that the Python kernel is busy right now. There is written kernel busy. Once that clears out, that means you are good to go. Okay. Now you can see this is just a red color or a pink color in particular box, which states some future warnings. Basically, there might be some future changes in your library. So it is just giving that warning. It has nothing to do with any kind of error which is happening here. So you can completely ignore this entire box. That's it. And in case if you want to, if you don't want to ignore it, and you don't want to see this in a Jupyter notebook, all you need to do is just, first I'm going to add another cell here by pressing escape A. A gives a line above and B gives a line, escape B gives a line below. And I'm going to import warnings library. A tiny tinsy mistake of spelling here. Okay, now we are good to go. Now I'm going to simply write warnings. Dot tab. and I am going to use simple filter method here. Press tab if you want to know more about this particular library, this particular method. I am writing ignore here because I want to ignore this entire warning message. So I am writing ignore here, comma. If I press tab again, what kind of warning do you want to ignore? You can simply specify. So I am writing category. Now each warning has a separate meaning. So what I am going to do is, instead of writing here the spelling, I am just going to copy this part which says future warning, and not within the quotations obviously. There is no error. That means we have done a good job. Now I am going to run this again, and you see you do not have any kind of a warning box anymore on this page. So now let's talk about the tips data. Now the tips data is basically wherein there is a restaurant which is managing there, or is in particular creating a data set wherein they are writing, they have the column as total bill, and on that total bill what is the tip and who paid that tip, or what was the gender of the person who paid the bill, then whether that person was a smoker or a non-smoker, and then on what day he or she was there to have lunch or dinner, that is the time, and what is the table amount, basically how many people are there the person has booked for. So here we have two here, three, and many more. So head method helps us see how many column to see a particular number of rows and all the columns of the data set, so we are able to understand what data has for us to offer. Now the second thing is that if you want to change the kind of background your plot has, you can just directly use sns.set_style method, and within that if you press let me just run that line first, and within that if you press shift tab, you'll get a lot more options here. You can either put a dark grid. Grid means that you'll have an intersection lines. White grid if you want a wide grid. If you want a completely dark background, which is sort of gray, and a white background, and so on and so forth. So if you want something, you want to change the background of your plot, you can simply do that with the help of set_style method. And I am writing white grid here so that I have white grids behind my graphs. Now let's see how we can make this particular graph. Okay, now I'm just importing I'm just using import numpy as np here, and I'm going to create a bar plot. Now one must ask a question, that you might have a question that if it is a bar plot, what is this? We are definitely going to talk about it in a while, but first let's see how we can create a bar plot in seaborn library. So here I have sns.barplot method. Within that, generally what happens is that the bar plots are more we create bar plots in the sense to have a visual representation of the frequency of the categories which are available in a column, right? And against that, if we want to see, suppose that how much a person paid, a gender, specific gender paid of what they for what they had, so we can directly plot a bar plot with on that particular data. So here I have male, here I have female, and we have the frequency of bill in our data set. But in reality, generally what happens, the concept is that bar plot basically gives you a frequency. But in SNS, in Seaborn, bar plot basically gives you averages by default. So here x equals to sex, that is the gender, or either someone is a male or a female, and on y axis we have total bill, and the data which we are using is tips. We have to mention this data argument because we are not connecting anything to our data set, so we need this data argument so that we can link this bar plot method to our data set. Now by default what happens is that this bar plot method, instead of giving us frequencies or counts, it gives us it gives us mean by default. If we want to change this, we can directly do that by specifying either we want standard deviation or we want length of that frequency of that total bill of male and female or something like that. So for now on we'll just going to leave it like so, and we are going to press shift enter here. By simply using sns.barplot, by using a method in particular, we can directly create a plot which shows us what is the average amount of bill male paid and what is the average amount of bill female gender paid, and we have a graph like so with a white grid at the back end of it. So male and female. In case, as I said, that in case you want something like what is the standard deviation of the bill, the male and the female category paid, so you can directly use, press shift tab here. What I like to do is I like to copy paste the argument instead of writing it so that I do not make any spelling mistakes, because you have to be very particular when you are using a method argument. Now what I am going to do, the reason now why I imported NumPy is so that I can use NumPy arithmetic methods to build my plot. So standard deviation method is in within NumPy library, so that is why I am just going to write np dot std and change the plot default value from mean to standard deviation, and I am going to run this entire thing. Here we go, we have total underscore bill male female with slightly different graph. You might not be able to notice the changes, so let's change this again and look at the difference which it has. So here I have the length, the y axis, the maximum length is 10, and here we have the gender male and female. Now I have just removed the estimator argument from the bar plot. Let's run it again. Now I have the y axis values as limit values as from 0 to 20 instead of 0 to 10. So now we know that the graph is actually changing and we are actually getting the standard deviation of male and female in particular. In case if you want to check, if in case you want to cross check, what you can do is use data, okay, our data name is tips, so I'm, instead of writing data I'm going to write data tips square bracket, then sex dot group by. Group by method basically categorizes your column and gives you only the category in particular. So here I have sex as male and female. So this is going to calculate for one category, for each and every category, it is going to calculate the values separately. Or you can just directly write tips dot group by sex dot mean. Here we have tips for male, it is 20.744, and for female it is 18.05. Now this particular, see, this group method has categorized the male and the female values differently, and also has given us the total bill, but it is also giving us tips and size column, because they are numerical in nature. The data type is numerical. So what we can do is, instead of writing directly using mean directly on these groups, what we can do is we can call upon the total bill column, that is total underscore bill. Again, I will recommend you to copy the column name instead of writing it directly, so that there is no spelling mistake. And then I am going to use mean method, and here we go, we have male total bill as 20 point, on an average the bill is not total bill, but the average is 20.74, and here I have for female it is 18.05. now let's compare. So male is 20 point something, so you can see that the male bar is somewhere near 20 point something, and for female it is somewhere near 18 point something. So hence prove the bar graphs are correct in terms of averages. Now if I want to add a standard deviation here, I am going to use np.st in the estimator argument, and then what I am going to do is, I am again going to change this mean method from mean method, I am going to change this from std to std, and here I have male as 9.24 and female as 8.90092. let's check. Male is 9.24, approximately 9.24, we are in the right direction, and female is 8.00. so let's see, approximately 8.00. that means we have correctly plotted the graph. And now let's talk about what is this. This is called the error bar. I am just going to change . So this is the error bar. So what happens is that when you are calculating the averages, how far the values are away from the actual average, it shows that. So on an average, let me just explain it. Like, now suppose that I have a x data, and what happens in this x column is that, suppose that the average of the entire data in this column is 20, so the bar tells you how far on an average by max the values vary from this average, and maximum is this portion and the minimum is this portion. So suppose that here I have my mean value as 20. Around that mean, how far on the maximum side my data varies, and on the minimum side how far my data varies. It tells you the error plot tells you that. So that's that. Now if you want to add labels here, suppose that here it is giving us automatic labels. Now here it is not mentioned what is the title of this entire graph. So suppose if you want the title of your graph, so what you're going to do is you're going to use the matplot library, that is we have named it as plt dot, and we are going to press tab, and we are going to use title method, and within that title method I am going to write tips data. Once I run that, it will form a combination of Seaborn library bar plot and a plt method and a plt dot title method in particular. Now I have a tips data as my title, and here I have my total bill column name and sex column name. So this is what we can do with the help of the plt, with the help of a combination of plt methods, and that is matplot methods and Seaborn methods. We have used Seaborn to create a bar plot, and here in the second line what we are doing is we are using the plt.title method to give a title to our graph. Now you see that we have a text coordinate here, right? So what we are going to do is we are going to write plt.show so that the above line or the text coordinates are removed from that entire graph or the output in particular. So I hope that this made sense, and I hope that you learned something from this video. If you want to know more about DexLab Analytics, please click on the website, or just go to the website www.dexlabanalytics.com, and if you want to read about this, and if you want the contents of this particular video, you can just in the description box click on the link which will directly take you to the blog link, blog which I have written, which also have all the codes and all the methods which I have used in this particular code sheet. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time. Bye bye. Take care.